We're gonna try and work through some tools here now to kind of figure out what weights and loads you might be comfortable muscle snatching with, nice and fast. What workouts that might be best for you to do. Being fast, right? That's a huge one, but not sloppy and out of control. So we're gonna work with some touch and go reps. A lot of times we'll see people when they try to go fast, the bar just kind of goes forward of the body. And that's not what I want to see. So Chris, show us a few good touch and go snatches. Just do a muscle snatch for now. Okay, and relax. So if you guys watch Chris, it even goes like a profile view. You can see kind of the way the bar travels up and down. Okay, on the way up and the way down. Common flaws we'll see when people try to go fast here, it's just whoosh, bar goes swooping out, especially when they return, where the bar goes more towards the foot. All right. Either way, increased distance gonna leave more time taken to do the lift. So a key note here though, using a hook grip, if you have a workout that involves a grip and then a grip intensive movement, using a hook grip might save your grip a little bit more for those other movements. Lastly, dropping. When do you drop the weight during a conditioning workout? This is typically where it's associated with, I need to rest, I need to catch my breath, and an eccentric return. It's just, boom, my lungs are just way too high. We drop, and we come on back up. We can definitely take a much longer time doing that over and over and over again. So if you are a dropper from overhead, make sure at least you're getting the most bang for your buck on touch and goes first before you go to drop. And when you do drop, make sure it's not one of those things where dilly-dallying around, getting reset, doing the movement. But you can get your grip set fast, but to go ahead and drive back up in that sucker. All right? Hit the pockets, fully extend, bar goes overhead. We can go even faster in the return than what gravity allows us. So if I can think about getting up and actively pulling that bar back down to the ground, I might be able to save some time with that. All right? So, yeah, so show them without and then show them pulling it down. Be careful with this if someone says, so this is without pulling it down. Now pull it down. Okay. A little bit faster, would you agree? So if you have a load there, we can go, boom, and then pull that sucker back down, almost like you guys do with the swing. When that's involved in a workout, you swing up, you try and pull that sucker back down if you can. The same principle we can apply it here, as long as you're still focusing and having that up and down bar path happening there. As long as that travel doesn't continue to go outwards, which can be kind of tricky to do. So now we're failing muscle snatch or muscle clean. We're not no longer do it fast. We gotta go to the power versions. And Chris, show me one real quick. All right, so we're here with catching the rebend and standing. Now, a couple other considerations to take here with the power versions. One, just minimizing the catch, okay, the bend in the leg. So ideally, we can catch as high as possible, all right, and just have a couple inches of stand rather than catching a touch lower and having more distance to travel as needed, all right? Some people land wide and then have to take time at the top to reset their feet, all right? So if you don't have to reset your feet to stand, we get much more efficient rather than having to reset your feet between reps. Think about these two aspects here, being touch and go and fast, still having that good efficient line of action, still touch and going and having your good grip, and also do a few reps where you get it up, you drop, you're back down to the bar, right back up again, right? Just really minimizing that transition time from the drop. I think most people now, it's nothing but moderate to moderately heavy loads we kind of practice this movement with, but there's a different technique for both, we think. You gotta ask yourself the first thing up there, do you wanna get full hip extension when you drive up or not? I'm not a fan of teaching don't fully extend the hip, I'm not. When it comes game time, it might be a little bit quicker. If we have a light load, don't fully extend the hip. That's something to consider when the weight's light. Next, your foot starting position. If you can start with your feet in a squat position to start, you're gonna save some time transitioning from that jump to a catch. So if we're here, he can keep his feet in the same spot. This can be more successful and more fast than if he starts with his feet narrower and lands with his feet a touch wider and has to reset his feet between every single rep. Catching low or high, kind of also independent of the individual, Usually with moderate loads, if you're someone that kind of lacks shoulder mobility or the weight's a little challenging for you, catching high and riding her down might be your best option rather than catching, trying to be super quick under the bar and biffing the weight. All right. If it gets a little unsteady there for you, maybe catching it in that three-quarter squat or quarter squat and riding it down consistently might be your best option. And I'd be faster in your pull under. Yeah.